Becoming a PNGtuber is a smart and effective way to showcase some presence without having to be on camera. Whether it's for live streaming, YouTube videos, TikTok, I'm gonna show you by far the easiest way to set it up within OBS Studio. I'm also gonna share a couple of ideas on how you can get your artwork without having to commission an artist. Yet, but if you have the budget, I will suggest an artist. But before all that, if you want to create content, you need to check out today's sponsor. And today's sponsor is Owned Pro. Owned is already known for having the biggest overlay and alerts pack on the internet. But using your free Owned Pro account, you can install them with one click. You also get access to a Twitch chatbot, a customizable dashboard, a huge library of alerts, you have gold bars, you have countdown feature, there's a link spree, a donation page, you can check your stats, I already mentioned a gazillion overlays, royalty-free music, and pretty cool Twitch extensions. This one gives you animated panels. This one will show up alerts even if you're streaming from console, and this one lets you trigger alerts that will show up on your whole screen. So go check it out over at own.gg/gallevelpro. That is own3d.gg/gallevelpro. So let's do this. Your first step is to download the image reaction plugin. There will be a link in the description. All you have to do is click download here, and we're gonna download for Windows. So we downloaded the zip file. I'm gonna double click here and click on the readme, and this will explain how to install it. You want to extract it, right click, and it's gonna say unzip, or in my case, I have WinRAR. I can click extract here. So now we have the extracted folder, double click, and basically we need to copy and paste those two folders in the OBS directory. So select them, right click, copy, and go find wherever you have OBS installed. For me, it's C, program files, OBS Studio. Then here you can right click and click paste. Then if OBS was already open, you want to close it and open it back up. Okay, now I'm going to create a new scene, call it PNGtuber. And then when I go to add a new source, I should have this new option called image reaction. Click OK. I'm not gonna name it. And you'll see your options. Image when silence, image when sound. Now, I already made some tutorials about PNGtubers, so I have a couple of examples. My favorite one being from Lord of the Rings, of course. So that's the image during silence. So that'll be the image when I'm not talking. Then we're gonna click image when sound, and this one should appear when I'm talking. So pay attention to the options. Reset animation of the first image after reaction. That is because this source actually accepts animated GIFs. Why would you want to use an animated GIF? For example, you can have your character be idle, maybe slowly moving, maybe blinking. So this option would reset the animation basically every time you talk. There's also unload image when not showing. I guess that might save some resources on your computer. Apply alpha in linear space, which I have no idea what that means. Okay, audio source, and this is where you pick your mic or whatever you wanted to react to. And I'm gonna pick mic auxiliary. Testing. and then there's reaction threshold. This is where you can, when it basically triggers. And a good way to figure that out is to basically check out your audio here. As you can see, if I'm continuously talking, it's not moving up and down. So I might want to bring that up a little bit. In that case, it's going to be like more sensitive, I guess. It's going to end up only moving when I reach like the peak of my voice. But it's for you to play around with it. I'm going to keep it around minus 40 dB or decibels. There's also smoothness. Let me bring that all the way up. Testing. And that's basically like a slight delay in when it triggers. When it's at zero, it might seem way harsher, as you can see. Okay, so those are PNG images with transparent backgrounds. So there you go. I really can't. So you can add them to whatever scene you want. What do I have? Now I can add this as a scene. I can click on the plus here, go to scene, and then pick PNGtuber. Now I have my PNGtuber wherever. I should probably crop the empty space, but there you go. It's really, it's really that simple. For a better example, we can switch it up. Here I have two pictures of myself, and for a more, I guess, natural-ish feeling, so you don't have scary Bilbo Baggins. But also, if people are already used to your face, this is great. All right, so all you need is two images, one with the mouth closed and one with the mouth open. If you don't want to use pictures of yourself, one of the easiest ways to obtain like artwork is to use the Bitmoji creator. So on your phone, on your camera options, you probably have this, you can create your own Bitmoji. All you have to do is take a picture of it with the mouth closed and the mouth open, and then you can import it. I had the option to put mine on a green screen so I can remove the background directly in OBS. Mouth closed, mouth open. happen. Just like that. If I click OK, you can see the quality on this. I can hold Alt to crop, by the way, just like that. And I can right click, go to filters, click plus. Let's add a color key, click OK. And under color key type, we want to pick a custom color. Select color and then pick screen color. So click here and then click on the screen. So now it knows which color to key out. Click OK. Boom, there you go. Now you play around with the settings until it suits you. And just like that, we have a little bit of presence on screen. You can set it wherever you want. And for the just chatting scene, you can just pick a cool background for it. So that's just one example on how to quickly get things going. On this AR Bitmoji creator, I also had other characters. So if I wanted to be a cute dragon or whatever they have, that's also a possibility. There's also a bunch of online generators where you can create your own customized like chibi creator. All you have to do is swap out the mouth to create one with mouth closed and one with mouth open. And then you're good to go. Another way of doing it is using TikTok filters, for example. They have a huge variety of filter that does pretty much everything. Now, to remove the background, you might have to drop it in Canva and just click remove background, or Adobe Express and click remove background. Both of those are free and you're good to go. Now, if you really want to have a cool, cute character originally made for you, you can contact my friend Nobe. She is an artist and she does commissions. There will be a link in the description to her Ko-fi page where you can commission her directly. Watch my other PNGtuber videos if you want more options like slowly moving, shaking, blinking, and all that stuff. Also, while you're at it, subscribe.